there are people in the FOSS world that make money here, that have a job in FOSS, that is awesome. But most people are volunteers. Here's the thing though, some things aren't free. Build infrastructure, package mirrors, mailing lists, IRC and Matrix servers, and in a lot of these cases, there are free things you can use to actually get up and running. But if you want to control your project's infrastructure, generally that's gonna cost some money. And there are a lot of sponsors that exist in the FOSS world, don't get me wrong, but there's one you may have heard about recently that is way bigger than you'd probably expect that right now is kind of in jeopardy. That being the Oregon State University, more specifically, the Open Source Lab. They provide hosting services to a bunch of different projects. General hosting for things like a mailing list or a build server for like an x86 server, things like that. And also having architecture-specific hardware as well. ARM64, OpenPower, Power Continuous Integration, and IBM Z. Most of this probably doesn't see that much use. ARM64, I can definitely see, you know, especially for like Chromebook stuff or RC Linux style stuff. Like, this is something that's definitely going to be used. But this is the main thing, right? Like, this is very, very important. And you may not have heard about the Open Source Lab, so you might be thinking, well, they can't be that important, right? Like, how many things are really using their services? Well, here's some notable milestones over the years. Provided hosting for Mozilla Firefox when they needed help in the early days and hosted the release of 1.0. Was the home of the Apache Software Foundation, the Linux Foundation, kernel.org, and Mozilla for many years. Offers fast and reliable software mirroring for projects. Currently provides infrastructure hosting for projects such as Drupal, Gentoo Linux, Debian, Fedora, PHPBB, OpenID, Buildroot/BusyBox, Inkscape, Sync, and many more. I'll get to the many more in just a moment. And virtual machines for all of these infrastructures are used by many projects for CI and other hosted services. So, this right here is a full list of everybody they're providing hosting for. Now, the extent they're providing hosting for depends on the specific project, so this being in trouble is a bigger deal for some than others. For example, Arch Linux, right here. Some of their mirrors are done by the Open Source Lab, but they have a bunch of other mirrors as well. And there's a lot of other projects here. If you don't recognize at least a couple of projects on this list, I don't think you use Linux. I'm going to speed up the scrolling just so we can get through to the end. Need I say more? Basically, every notable FOSS project either currently uses, has used in the past, or is in some way directly connected to a project receiving hosting from the Open Source Lab. Again, different projects to different extents. Like I was saying before about Arch Linux, if we look at Alpine Linux, they receive PowerPC support from them. So if that was left behind, yes, that's a problem for their PowerPC side, but the distro could still function. Gentoo, however, they could still function without the Open Source Lab, but they would be hit a lot more than certain other projects. Now, here is a post on the Open Source Lab blog by Lance Albertson about what is going on. Future of OSL in jeopardy. I am writing to inform you about a critical and time-sensitive situation facing the Open Source Lab. Over the past several years, we have been operating at a deficit due to a decline in corporate donations. While the Oregon State College of Engineering has generously filled this gap, recent changes in university funding makes our current funding model no longer sustainable. As a result, our current funding model is no longer sustainable. Wait, did I just... Hold up. Did I just read that twice? Recent changes in university funding makes our current funding model no longer sustainable. As a result, our funding model is no longer sustainable. No, I read that correctly. It just says the same thing twice. Unless we secure $250,000 in committed funds, the OSL will shut down later this year. I have reached out to our largest corporate sponsor, and they are working to increase their support as we update our contract, but that still may not be enough. Reading this the first time, I was very confused, and frankly still am confused, how it's been allowed to get that bad. You say operating at a deficit for a number of years. This seems like a problem you should have dealt with before you had $250,000 you had to secure. For transparency, the $250,000 is broken down into the following roughly. Staff pay, $150,000 for one staff. Student pay, $65,000 for 8 students. And other expenses, $35,000. Other expenses include items such as hardware, travel, subscription services, and other miscellaneous expenses needed to run the OSL day to day. This is another one I'm kinda confused about. The $150,000 for the one staff member. That seems like a really high salary for what this position is. And yeah, like network admin, sure, like it's generally a good paying position, but look, is this normal in Oregon? Look, I don't know Oregon rates. Maybe that's normal in Oregon, but that seems really high. Granted, the OSL does do more than just manage these servers, as is explained over in the FAQ. What will you use my donation for? And the breakdown you see here is from 2019, and assuming they haven't had any major cuts since then, it's likely their operating expenses have gone up since then. So it's not like not having this money takes them down to zero, it's not having this money doesn't cover everything they were already paying for. Below are a few examples of where we spent money in the past year. That again is 2019, but it would be very similar for today as well. Staff and student salaries. We spend nearly 62% of our budget on staff and student salaries. This also includes any benefits we pay to full-time staff, and all of the students we employ receive higher hourly wages compared to the average OSU student worker. Travel. When funding allows, we send our staff and students to open source conferences. This enables the OSL to stay on top of new technologies, along with sharing experiences and ideas we've learned hosting FOSS projects. Of course, there is bandwidth and infrastructure equipment as well, and also community events. Another part of our budget is dedicated towards supporting community events such as Beaver Bar Camp and DevOps Bootcamp. These events allow us to broaden our exposure to students at OSU and the community. So the hosting is definitely important to the FOSS space, but there are other things they do and things you just really can't get rid of, like the, you know, the salaries. Now, are the salaries potentially higher than I would expect them to be? Look, again, I don't know what the norm in Oregon is, but even if that was lowered, it wouldn't cover for the $250,000. What will happen if you don't meet your fundraising goal? Our foremost goal is continue to provide world-class hosting services to open source projects. Should we fail to meet our fundraising target, we will be forced to reevaluate our priorities and eliminate some of the lab's activities. This decision, should it need to be made, will be discussed with the OSU OSL Advisory Council and decided upon with OSU leadership. So it's very possible they'll have to cut back on the amount of projects they're supporting, maybe cut back on some of the more expensive ones, maybe cut back on certain architecture they're providing, like, hey, do we need IBMZ? Do we need OpenPower? Most of what's being done is the general hosting. You have to start making tough decisions like that on what you want to keep around. If any of you can assist or connect me with potential supporters, say, I don't know, Jeff Bezos, do you happen to be watching this video? If you do and you like open source, or maybe you're a lottery winner and you want to waste all of your money before you go and buy a yacht, this is a good cause to waste your money on. I need to provide leadership with an update on any funding changes by Wednesday 14, 2025. As of the recording of this, that would be 8 days away. The OSU Foundation is an IRS 501c3 nonprofit corporation which provides many donors a tax advantage. Please contact the OSU Foundation directly if you have questions about your eligibility. You can donate directly to us by visiting our donation page. Obviously, they are still looking for individual donations, and individual donations, you know, very important. But to quickly cover $250,000, which I do think they should have probably made a big deal about this before 14 days from where they need to raise the money. Big money, corporate sponsors, that sort of stuff is very important to make this happen. Now, I'm sure there are other ones that I'm not aware of, but a bunch of the affected projects have gone and made posts about this. Firstly, we have Inkscape. The Oregon State University's open source lab needs your help. We at Inkscape rely on them for hosting our website, mailing list, mail servers, and DNS. They're also a host for a bunch of other projects as well. Please consider donating to them. Next, we have PostmarketOS. OSU OSL has been around for 22 years. They kindly host our GitLab for 6 months now and provide important services for more than 150 other free and open source software communities, such as all of these. I think it's actually over 200. Yeah. Liberachat. If you're reading this post, you have benefited from the OSU OSL. Projects supported by them power today's internet infrastructure. We know that OSU OSL is worth saving, but we need organizations that rely on the internet to get on the same page. OpenZFS. Various OpenZFS resources are hosted at OSU OSL in Corvallis, Oregon, and their funding is threatened. They host many critical open source projects, and we thank them for their excellent service. And Rocky Linux. The beacons are lit. OSU OSL calls for aid. Oregon State University Open Source Lab will shut down this year if funding is not met. Among countless other open source projects, OSL supports Rocky Linux by hosting our PPC64LE and S390X build environments. Now, I'm a bit late to this story because there's a lot of things that I like to talk about in this channel, but this hasn't really received much in the way of coverage. There is an article over on the Register. It got some comments on it. There was an article over on Pharonix, which once again got some comments on it. And at least over on the Hacker News thread, this got quite a bit of attention. But outside of Mastodon, where most of the discussion has been happening, I don't think people really know this is even going on and have no idea the extent that the OSU OSL actually supports the FOSS ecosystem. Now, you could say, oh, the university makes a ton of money, they could easily go and support this, and yeah, that could very easily happen. It's just, the university doesn't only exist for the open source lab, and sadly, there's a lot of other things that'll be vying for money that people in the university are gonna think are a lot more important than what some nerds are doing over here with the engineering department. And even though this infrastructure is so very important, and a lot of these other systems wouldn't be able to function without the work being done in the FOSS world, it's just sadly the world we live in. A lot of people just don't realize how important this FOSS infrastructure actually is. So if you're in a position to support the lab, if you're maybe in a position to wrangle some corporate funding, even better, reach out to them. Do what you can do. That would be awesome. But until then, if you like the video, go like the video. If you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe, the Liberapay linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and money makes the world go round.